It's Conduit News Radio with Paul Harrell.
To the program, we've got Republican pioneer, the myth, the man, the legend. We've got Gene McVay with us. Gene, welcome, sir. Good morning to you.
Hey, good morning, Paul. We missed you at Springdale last night.
Well, how did it go? Tell us what the event was and tell us what you talked about.
Well, Jeff Olin put together an outstanding event at the historical AQ Chicken House restaurant in Springdale. And Jeff allowed Joe Maynard to speak before Jan Morgan gave us a rousing speech. It was like a rock concert there. The people were electrified and excited. And so you really missed an event.
Well, I'm glad it went so well. I did see, I think, a Facebook Live, at least a little bit of the attendance, and the room seemed pretty packed. And I'm seeing this everywhere, you know, up in my neck of the woods where I live up here in Northeast Arkansas. Jan came up a couple, I guess maybe a month or month and a half ago, and she packed out a room to the likes. You know, I've been following politics up here for a while. I've never seen a turnout like that for anybody. And so she really is, you know, having quite the draw.
It's a movement.
Yeah. So what did you talk about when you got up there and discussed Gene McVay? What did you have to say?
Well, I was struck by the way the Democrats, and not just the ordinary Democrats, but the far left fringe of the Democratic Party, how excited they are about Asa Hutchinson and how supportive they are. And I didn't get to talk a lot about that, but the fact that Jason Rappert supports Asa Hutchinson is not surprising. But when you have Max Brantley writing that at a Christmas party at a home just a few steps from the governor's mansion was something of a group therapy session for the several hundred liberals who dropped by. And then he said striking amid the political gloom was how often people pointed down the block and remarked how the occupant, Republican Asa Hutchinson, had been a bright light. Yes, let us now praise.
Now, is this a piece you're reading from? Again, is it, you're saying that this is a Max Brantley article, or did you say John Brumman? I'm sorry, I didn't hear that part.
Oh, no, this is a Max Brantley article.
Okay. Well, I'm getting confused because John Brumman writes good things about Asa, too.
Oh, yeah. Brumman is, he could be the cheerleader for Asa. In fact, Brumman wrote, let's put a constitutional amendment on the ballot to stop this damnable election of appellate judges. Mm-hmm. Vote for a governor you trust to make solid nominations. Actually, I trust Asa Hutchinson in this regard. Hmm. So,
yeah, you know, last week, we're talking with Gene McVay. Last week, I saw, you know, Brumman was out defending Asa again on the grocery tax, saying, you know, it's not spin. And he even argued that because it would affect the rich, that raising the grocery tax to the full 6.5% would be okay if they had some sort of low income tax credit, you know, for you know, poorer individuals. So that's interesting. But yeah, this is my thing. When is it going to, let me ask you this, Gene, do you think people thought, and I mean Republicans, and I mean even maybe moderate Republicans, do you think that they thought John Brumman and Max Brantley would be writing complimentary pieces on Asa Hutchinson back in November of 2014 when he was elected, and they called it for Asa at 7:33. It was a Republican sweep, massive Republican majorities. Do you think the rank and file thought that John Brumman would be defending Asa and writing a positive stories about Asa's leadership and that sort of thing?
Absolutely not. And I hate to say this, Paul, but John Brumman and Max Brantley knew more about Asa Hutchinson than the Republicans knew about Asa Hutchinson. Brummett wanted to let his liberal friends know that a victory for Asa Hutchinson would not be as bad as liberals had feared. And they saw Asa as having a better chance than Mike Ross for continuing Obamacare in Arkansas.
Wow. But that's, I never thought of that. That's exactly right. Go ahead.
How did John Brummett and Max Brantley know so much about Asa? Did they bump into Asa at an unlit tarmac and at the airport at Phoenix? Did they have Asa's phone wiretapped? Because they certainly knew what was coming. And Republicans, it was a shock to most Republicans.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, you're right about that, Gene. I mean, it is pretty incredible, and I guess what's deflating to me is how there still is so little. I mean, there is opposition in the Republican Party to the governor. Yes, there is, but as far as at the Marble Palace, there's not enough people. I mean, people will say things independently, but they're afraid to organize against the leadership. They're afraid to organize as Republicans against it, and yet there are so many there's so many factors to look at, and not to mention their policies that you're pursuing, not to mention it's universal rejection of the Republican leadership's direction, not just on the Conduit for Commerce scorecard, but for most all scorecards. They're unhappy with one way or the other, the Family Council or Americans Conservative Union or whatever. They're unhappy with their score there. And it's like, okay, you guys need to understand who you're following. So that's an indicator. And then you have the indicator of the liberal media. I mean, the liberal press cannot say a positive word about President Donald Trump, but they can't say enough about the leadership in Asa Hutchinson, Republican governor. They can't ever say a negative word. Now, there's something about that picture that doesn't make sense.
Absolutely. That's absolutely true. And Asa, well, when he had the national spotlight, do you remember when he made his speech at the Republican National Convention? And he blasted Hillary Clinton for her support of Obamacare?
Yes.
He sounded like a conservative. But then, when Hillary Clinton showed up at the University of Arkansas Pine Bluff, she only had glowing remarks for Asa Hutchinson. She said, "I'm really supportive of what Governor Hutchinson is trying to do to make sure Obamacare stays here in Arkansas."
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah, let me, matter of fact, the article that you just referenced, I just sent over to Joe. I'm going to throw it up on the screen here. This was back on July 19th of 2016. You weren't the only one that saw the hypocrisy here. Okay. The headline, "Arkansas Governor Bashes Clinton on Health Care, Yet Backs Key Obamacare Provision." Arkansas Governor Asa Hutchinson used part of his speech Tuesday night at the Republican convention to bash Hillary Clinton over health care without mentioning the way he has earned scorn from conservatives by the way he has implemented Obamacare in his own state. Asa said Clinton offers more of the same failed top-down approach to health care where Washington tells the states what to do. But in Arkansas, Hutchinson has become an unlikely advocate of expanded Medicaid coverage, one of Obamacare's core components. Joe, see if you can pull up the Hillary Clinton video, because I want, while we've got Gene McVay on, go ahead and pull that up. It's at 2350. But yeah, Gene, let me get your reaction to what I just read.
Well, it's something that maybe Arkansas Republicans will start to wake up to. But the fact is, Asa Hutchinson is not who he claims to be. In fact, when most of the leadership and Asa Hutchinson endorsed Marco Rubio, they thought that would be the turning point. And I don't know if you remember what Asa said, but he said it is up to Arkansas to stop the Donald Trump show.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The next generation of conservatives cannot allow Donald Trump to take everything we stand for and throw it away.
Yeah.
And now we know everything they stand for. And it's big government, socialized medicine, sky-high taxes, and pork barrel spending.
Well, you know, I mean, I was not a Trump supporter during the primary, and I was very worried about his candidacy as well. I did vote for Donald Trump, obviously over Hillary Clinton, but I took him getting the nomination pretty hard when it first happened. But I have to say that I was wrong. If you look at what Donald Trump has done, he's done amazing things. The mainstream media keeps trying to lay out all these nets for him, and they keep falling into their own nets. It's really something that's amazing. Saudi Arabia just recognized Israel's right to exist. North Korea may denuclearize. You know, we got tax cuts. I hope we get more tax cuts. There's a lot of stuff that's going on here. And, you know, but then you look at what Donald Trump did, getting rid of the individual mandate. And then you look at what Asa did when we were trying to repeal Obamacare. Asa went on MSNBC and was used as a Republican puppet so that MSNBC could say, oh, here's a Republican that doesn't support what Donald Trump is trying to do in repealing Obamacare. So you gotta wonder if he's, you know, come to the same conclusions that I've come to, or if he's trying to kind of fight what Donald Trump's trying to do. Go ahead, Gene.
Well, with all of that horsepower behind Marco Rubio, he was able to carry two counties in Arkansas in the primary, and then in the general election against the former First Lady of Arkansas and First Lady of the United States, Donald Trump won more than 60% of the vote. Ronald Reagan didn't get 60% of the vote the first time he ran. So the people of Arkansas, somehow there's a disconnect between the governor and the people that he governed.
Gene, you are a Republican pioneer, Gene McVay. You served in our military honorably, and I appreciate your service. And you were a Republican. You really were a Republican when it wasn't cool to be a Republican. And you worked in the grassroots and everything else. And so when you see the state of Arkansas now, and you listen to Hillary Clinton come to Arkansas and compliment Asa Hutchinson, when she said this, I want to get your reaction. Here's Hillary Clinton when she was running in a primary against Bernie Sanders. She stopped by Arkansas. She said this.
Governor, now Asa Hutchinson, the current Republican governor, have been among the most creative leaders in the country to figure out how to expand Medicaid in Arkansas, to take care of, you know, more than 100,000 people last time I checked. And you know what that's meant? That's meant not only that people got health care, it's also meant that rural hospitals have stayed open that are closing in states that refuse to extend Medicaid. And I know it's a favorite issue on the Republican right, and I know how hard it is to try to do something as important as extending Medicaid, but I'm proud of Arkansas. I go around bragging on this state because this was bipartisan. The Republican legislature had to approve it, and I am really supportive of what Governor Hutchinson is trying to do to make sure it stays here.
All right, so
Arkansas.
Gene McVay, Republican pioneer, in the grassroots, you worked hard. What are your thoughts on hearing that?
Well, I think you can probably imagine. Back in 1972, I ran for state senator, and that was before they had the gerrymandering going on in Arkansas. My district was all of the counties of Baxter, Boone, Marion, Searcy, and Newton. And if I could imagine that we'd have a two-party system and that things would turn out like they've turned out with legislation being passed with 100% of the Democrat vote and just a handful of Republicans, I would not have believed it. Absolutely would not have believed it.
Yeah.
And after I ran for the Senate, I got more votes than anybody serving in the Arkansas legislature except for my opponent. And I was defeated, but I became the Baxter County Republican chairman, and we worked on a two-party system. We couldn't even imagine having a majority, but just having more than one or two members of the legislature would have been a victory. Hmm. And so we've had a slap in the face with the way that our Republicans are governing.
Mm-hmm. I agree. We're talking with Gene McVay, Republican pioneer. We have a question for you that's coming in on our Facebook feed over at facebook.com/conduitnews. Mark writes, "Hey, ask Gene how the pressure tactics of Asa and company differ from other governors he has known. Contrast the style for us. People think what Asa is doing is normal." And so if we look, Gene, you know, you've got Asa pressuring Republican committees to disinvite Jan Morgan to speak. We have, you know, recently him, you know, kind of trying to figure out the billboard owners of who's putting up Jan Morgan billboards and that sort of thing. So can you answer that question for us? How is Asa's style compared to past governors? Is it normal?
Well, it's absolutely not normal. I envision that Asa drags these Republicans into his office, and he tries to intimidate them like he tried to intimidate Hannah Webb over the billboard. And the difference is that you can't intimidate Hannah Webb, a college student. But unfortunately, we have some snowflake Republican legislators that melt when Asa Hutchinson takes them to the woodshed. Hmm. And we're supposed to have three separate branches of government, but they're pretty much all under Asa Hutchinson's authority right now, and they fear Asa Hutchinson because he has so much money, and he will make sure they have a primary opponent.
Well, this,
and so they don't have the courage to stand up to him.
And that goes back to, I think, kind of our original point when we were talking about John Brumman and Max Brantley and these liberals that knew that Asa was going to be so lukewarm, he was going to get elected on popular conservative ideas but then not implement them. But if Mike Ross had been elected governor, it would have been worse for the Democrats because Mike Ross would have vetoed many of the policies attempted, but the legislator would have just overridden the vetoes because the governor constitutionally is actually not that powerful. Is not very powerful when it comes to lawmaking because you just can override the veto with a simple majority. So this kind of goes back to the same, you know, the same point of there wouldn't necessarily be. I mean, what a Democrat governor wouldn't have the same pull of intimidation that a Republican governor does who's not a true conservative.
Well, the intimidation started with the Speaker of the House, Davy Carter, and the President Pro Tem, Michael Amara. They were arm twisting to get this Obamacare passed. And you remember Davy Carter even sent the state police out to pick up one of the representatives and drag them back to vote on Obamacare.
Yeah, well, didn't he have to? I don't remember specifically, but didn't he have like an emergency dental procedure that needed to be done or something? I can't remember.
He did, but they didn't care if he was on his deathbed.
Yeah.
Just like Asa Hutchinson didn't care that Jake Files was under indictment. As long as he was going to vote for Asa Hutchinson, that's all that mattered.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Well, hey, Gene, I appreciate you being on the program. We're out of time this morning, but again, I appreciate all your work, and I appreciate your perspective as somebody who's seen, you know, the changes in this state. And I think what we're really saying is not a lot has changed. I mean, we've changed the color of T-shirts we're wearing from blue to red, but we really haven't seen the reforms the people have been voting for the last few election cycles. And I'll give you the last word, Gene McVay.
Well, listen, Paul, we really appreciate you. We appreciate Conduit. And keep up the good work.
Okay, I will. Gene, be safe. Folks, we're going to take a break. This is Conduit News Radio. Back in just a moment.